So how many licks of a Tootsie Pop does it really take to turn you into a monster? Yes, it's true. Researchers have discovered that kids who eat too much candy are more likely to be arrested for violent behavior later as adults. Here's one of those kids now eating a sucker.
Could have just been feed here.
I'm sorry. I don't even know where they get this tape. Anyway, British eggheads studied thousands of wee ones born in 1970 for about four decades, that's 40 years, Bill, and found that 70% became dangerous criminals by the time they were 34. That's a lot of math. Mm. The real culprits, though, are the parents. To paraphrase one of the authors of this study, mom and dads who bribe their brats into good behavior with candy could be doing harm and should probably be shot with a crossbow.
Wow.
Mm. I can't believe these people. Meanwhile, a parrot took some liberties.
You are being shagged by a rare parrot. He thinks you are.
What candy did you have as a kid?
I'm glad I didn't see that. What a show.
I need to see that over and over again.
You are being shagged.
Shagged by a rare parrot.
Oh, wow. That was one really warm.
That has completely thrown me off. Jonathan. Try to concentrate on the issue at hand, not at the shagging parrot. Do you buy this, that actually eating candy as a child will turn you into a hardened criminal?
Greg, I think there's a pretty obvious statistical fallacy here, right? I mean, kids who grow up eating a lot of candy, they probably don't have great parents. So, you know, they grow up with both bad nutrition and bad morals. Mm-hmm. But, you know, for me, if I'm going to pig out, it's not going to be on candy. It's going to be in, like, on a gyros. It's going to be on a tamale. It's going to be on a burger. It's not going to be on candy. So I don't think we should start restricting Hershey's sales just yet.
Well, you know what? I had great parents, and all I did for, like, 15 years was eat nothing but candy. They just put me in a room and filled me with candy.
Well, you know what? It's because you were the youngest. They don't care by your time. Like, my mom's a dietitian, and she convinced me up until I was five that green beans was dessert. I did not know any better. I was like, I would get excited when I'd see a carrot. By my third brother, he was literally mainlining Yoo-hoos.
Really?
Yeah. She did not care anymore.
Isn't this just an attack on candy? Because as we know, candy is an inanimate object, and it can't fight back. Mm.
It can't fight back, and it gets short shrift every Halloween when people think that there's razor blades inside of it.
That's true.
This is all part of the candy conspiracy, and I'm going to parrot what Jonathan just said.
The way I look at it, Diana, I look at it as candy is basically booze for kids. Mm. I stopped eating candy once I discovered the joys and wonders of alcohol.
Mm. Yeah.
And it's just like, you know, kids need to have something to take them out of the misery of life.
Yes.
And isn't it really candy? Candy is like little vodka.
Yes. Yeah. You know what's so sad is I used to hide candy. Like, I would snort a pixie stick. There was nothing wrong with that. And I still do it to this day. Yeah. And you know what? I'm not that violent, but if you don't give me that code after the show, we're going down.
I do that to this day, too. That's code for Adderall.
I don't think that was a pixie stick you were snorting, but I'll tell the authorities differently.
Sorry.
All right.
Sorry.
Stay right there. The great actor...